right, we're at five after, so I figure go ahead and kick this thing off. I do have the two RCs sitting out there listed for us to keep track of the image spec and distribution spec. And I think distribution spec is ready to go ahead and release. We're waiting on one last one for image spec. One vote shy there.
I'm happy to screen share the distribution spec release. It looks like we just got all the votes. That make sense?
Go for it.
Hold on, I'm having.
A laptop issue or is it a Zoom issue?
Just I feel slow right now.
Okay.
Can you see?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay. All right, thanks everybody for who voted, Derek and Vince at the last minute here. Thank you. So I want to not mess this up this time. What's the right button? Create a merge commit.
Yeah, I would even not do squash anywhere by default.
Can we
So merge
disable that
commit is the
on the
wisdom.
repository? Yes.
Yeah,
I
I mean, we
mean,
can.
should we not allow it, or is there a way to make it the default?
I think when you change what you did last time, it probably keeps track of what you did.
Okay.
Might be per repository.
Okay, but we want merge commit.
Yep.
And then go get your individual tag commit and tag that one.
And we make both dot three and dot or dot four and four.
I think it's probably sub which is it supposed to be?
I think we determined it's supposed to be dot four, but
Yeah.
like we've just been doing both in case people consume them and okay.
You have to push tag yourself first. Got a different way to do this.
Just like to copy paste things. Thank you. Something wacky is going on. Oh, it doesn't exist yet. Right, does this look pretty good to people? Right, take silences. Go for it. All right. And then what I've been doing, or what we've been doing, is just making a duplicate release. Then I think we run get these locally. Right, that's that.
And I saw Tianan gave us an approve on the other one, so I can get working on that in a little bit. I'll probably do it after the meeting. It's just easier for me to not be on the screen while I'm running around doing my Git passwords and all that stuff. But to your question, Tianan, yeah, there wasn't anything major in this, whereas I think the goal is that we were hoping this would be the last RC before we can cut the final. And I think the only question is that going to be the case, or is there going to be other stuff? And I'm kind of looking toward Mike's comment when he was approving, saying he was approving re with reservations. And I'm not quite sure what to do with the reservations.
There was one specific point, which was there's a little bit of an inconsistency with the definition of descriptors in the distribution spec and the image spec. What he mentioned was there were some restrictions on the, I think it was in the distribution spec, the same restrictions don't apply on the other side. So you just get them consistent. I don't have a PR or anything to rectify that because I don't know exactly which way it should go. But that was the biggest concern that he raised. Do we want to have, do we need a GA milestone, or can we assume that? Because we don't have any dates or anything on that, right? So how do we want to proceed with that?
My own hope was to let this sit out there for, I don't know what, 2 weeks, and then after that, propose the final GA, assuming nothing else changed. But it depends if something else is going to have to change. We're going to have to get one more PR merge in the meantime.
Yeah, I think that as far as I understand, it's yeah, things should not change. Like the you should treat the final RC as the last release. So
I'm trying to follow exactly the DAG content and what would need to change in one spec or another to make Mike's concerns go away. I don't know what they are. I don't quite follow. All right, well, more readings need on that one. But yeah, I will work on the image spec one a bit here. Do we want to talk about? I'm assuming, Ron, that is probably you asking about the WG auth. Do we want to talk about that one?
Yeah, sure. So I'm driving. Can you just pull that thing up on your screen, Brandon?
Okay, I'll pull that up in a second.
So just to give some context, so this requirement came from one of the users, customers for Zot object. So there are a couple of features in Zot, and most of them require authentication of some form. So the requirement is that in one of the interfaces to interact with Zot, they are using basic authentication, and in another feature they want to interact with the bearer token authentication. So currently the model that I have seen so far is only one of them being enabled throughout. So if you pick basic, you pick basic throughout, or bearer, you pick bearer throughout. So after looking at the HTTP spec, it looks like whenever you return a 401, you can actually return multiple WWW authenticate headers, and you can in fact say that you both are supported. So pick whatever you want. So the clients can pick whatever they want based on the two headers that come out. That gives you flexibility on the authentication side. So this is something that I just wanted to bring up on what the community thought in terms of the requirement and whether this is something that we want to solve.
I suspect you'll be the first one that does multiple, so I'm not sure how various clients are going to react to that. But my first question is, how would clients prioritize between the two? Is it client decision as to which one they want to go to?
That is correct. I would think that is what they would do. So most likely the clients would say there is some policy enforced on the client side saying you do a basic supported, or you do bearer if supported, or prioritize. So I guess these are the options.
For folks that have clienty things, I guess Sajay, I'm looking toward you, Josh, toward the Crane side, anybody else that might have some client tooling out there? Thoughts on how projects that are querying a registry would react when they see that, or even Mobi or something like Containerd?
Yeah, this is probably best discussed further in the authentication work group, but I just wanted to bring it up here for the general audience first.
What I think an interesting exercise to see what the Go standard library returns for that header when there's multiple. Is it I feel like that's how the client tooling will end up working.
It depends on how you query the Go library, I believe, because you can say, give me this header as a single value. In that case, I don't know if you have an array of entries in there, if it's just going to give you one of them or if it concatenates them. But you can also query Go and ask for all of the header entries for a specific thing, and it's an array. And the spec probably allows you to concatenate both authenticate headers into the same header with like a delimiter between them. And so there's like multiple scenarios you have to worry about here. Say this after thinking of the allow header, because the allow header lets you do a lot of that, where you can either have multiple allow headers or you can concatenate one allow header with multiple entries.
So just curious, I mean, is this something that folks have encountered? I guess this has not been brought up or addressed. I'm guessing not. The answer is no.
No, I'm pretty sure you'll be the first if you did this.
Maybe I can share something we had a couple of conversations with when we did the registry at the first versions. There was internal tooling that could not do the whole bearer auth dance, and they were very simple, very simplistic clients. And at that point in time, those clients wanted only basic auth. So we had an option to choose. This was very early on when we were prototyping it, to kind of like use basic. But over the years, we have kind of like asked those clients to go away and do only bearer, because that's the only thing that we wanted to support. And we didn't want to get down the multiple auth question. I just posted a link to the RFC also, which has kind of like the spec itself calls the weakness created by multiple authentication schemes. That's the title in the spec for the RFC. So I don't know whether that's something we want to go down, but it's something we want to think about. Maybe even if the distribution spec did support multiple schemes, we would have to be pretty clear as the clients how they kind of like fall into this behavior. So it's just worth to think about it also. In general, I don't know whether we want to go back to basic, but there are clients that just can't do better with what we have seen before. But this was very early on, and very simple clients is what we know. Maybe Ram, is that the kind of scenario that you're looking at very simple clients that?
It is not just it's just a choice of software, right? It's just a choice of software pattern. So yes, you're right that the security is only as strong as the weakest link, right? So if one of the paths is weaker, then that is the only security you get. But the requirement was the piece of software that they were doing monitoring with Zard that used only basic auth, and the other the user authentication was using bearer. And they wanted to support both, and it is not possible today. So you have to pick one, right? So that's where this question came up. And realistically, I don't think you can claim things saying that yes, this is one path is stronger than the other, or at least as strong as the other, and so on and so forth. So if you cannot make such claims, then I don't know whether this is even viable.
Yeah, we chose that if you go basic, you go basic. There's no multiple schemes possible. That was our internal choice. But I think, and we said you can go, once you go better, you go better. We're not going to support both, is what the call that we made at that time. So but that's just for reference. I'm guessing every use case has its own set of requirements, right?
Correct. So it's so this is coming from an on-premise kind of requirement, right? Right. Where the customers have a wider choice of software they can pick and choose from. So whereas in a cloud environment, everything is integrated, so you can make sure you pick and impose, right? But that's not the same on the on-prem. So that's I think the dichotomy here. But anyway, so this is just something that I wanted to bring up. Just to discuss.
Good topic to discuss, and we can also revisit as well in the auth working group. Not sure we'll have more discussion over there, but maybe different discussion. All right. Speaking of working groups, I figured we haven't done much of an update lately on any of the working groups, so I threw that on the agenda, unless anybody had anything left on the auth headers. So figured quick update. I can throw one out there for the two that I'm on. And Marcin, if I miss anything, feel free to jump in. But image compatibility these days has been pretty active. And so we've been going through our use cases, getting those sorted out, and also have a few draft PR sitting out there of different proposals of what we're thinking of in terms of how to communicate that compatibility. And they are vastly different proposals. And so if you have any interest in giving feedback over there, those pull requests are sitting out and having people discuss them as we are in present time already. So feel free to have a look at those. A lot of it depends on what use cases we want to solve over there, because there are questions whether or not we want to solve this just for runtime use cases. Do we want to solve this for node provisioning use cases? Both, neither. A lot of those questions are floating around over there. So did I miss anything on that, Marcin?
No, everything got covered by you, so cool.
Cool. Yeah, that group's been being pretty active. The auth working group has been definitely slow for a good long while now, and I think it's mostly just I haven't had bandwidth to do much over there, and I don't think anybody else has either. And so got a few PRs merged finally over there in terms of just evaluating what things look like in terms of current clients authenticating into registries, what they do, what their workflow is. Do they generate some of these scope headers they're going in when they start querying a bearer auth token, or to get a bearer auth token? And so the next step, I think, is going to be to start actually putting together our ideas of what this will look like. The other thing I want to look at is what some of the RFCs, the HTTP specs, have out there that we can leverage so we're not rewriting a lot of that. But work over there has been pretty slow. So if anybody wants to contribute over there, more participation is always welcome. And the only other working group I can think of right now is the FreeBSD one that we just opened up. I don't know what the progress on that is, because I have not been following that anywhere. Is anybody here involved in that at all? And without Sam here, I think a bunch of those folks are probably just over in a Slack channel somewhere. I think they're trying to get a GitHub repo added, and we need to get Amy or Chris, somebody over there, to set that up and get the template update as well. But that one does exist. I just don't know the status of it.
Yeah, I think at least the last year or two, there has been a push from the FreeBSD community to join the this whole Kubernetes and containers ecosystem. So because the currently the ecosystem is mostly Linux and C groups and all of that, so that's where the bedrock is, right? So I think they're also trying to join this. And in the Zart project, they have actually come and given us some contributions too, just to make sure the Zart works on previously. So I think there is some work going on there. I don't know how active that group is though.
Yeah, I don't see anything in the FreeBSD Slack channel either. So I mean, there's stuff in there, but just nothing recent since they got it. So I don't know if they even have a meeting set up yet or any of that. But I suppose they did have a meeting set up. We would probably know, because I would see it in the recordings. I have not seen anything. So that's probably still in the spin up stage right now. So that's the update of all the working groups. Any other agenda items people want to talk about today? Otherwise, my working task after this is to go ahead and cut the release on image specs. So I'll be sure to do that later on. And we can also talk about anything else that's holding up the next release or any other features people want to see added. Or if you're all too quiet, we can call it a day here. Just as my mouse battery decided to die and I'm frantically changing batteries.
Thanks for getting the releases out.
Oh, I see your comment there, Jesse. If you're having a problem unmuting, I can probably get in here and get you to unmute in 1 second. If you have anything to say, just let me know in the chat and I can work on that. All right, sounds good. Stalled just long enough for me to get my battery changed, so. All right. Yeah, thanks everybody. We'll get this release cut. And anything that's blocking for this thing to try to get a GA out, now is a chance, because my hope is in 2 weeks we can go ahead and GA this thing. Knock wood. Don't want to jinx it, but that's the goal. So we will push and see if we can make that happen. All right. Take care, all.
Bye, all.
Bye.